In January 2021, the coastal city of Mamuju on the island of Sulawesi in central Indonesia was struck by a devastating earthquake measuring 6.2 on the Richter scale. The quake occurred at 2 a.m. while people were peacefully asleep in their homes. Over 100 people lost their lives, with over 3,000 injured and 90,000 displaced. Rescue efforts were hampered by strong aftershocks, power cuts, as well as landslides blocking access to some of the worst affected areas. Alhamdulillah, Crisis Aid Indonesia was one of the first organisations to arrive in the earthquake zone. Our community kitchen team instantly started to cook, pack, and distribute thousands of hot meals to the displaced people living in cold, damp tents. Our volunteers also distributed tents, food parcels, clothes, sleeping mats, blankets, mosquito nets, baby milk, as well as engaged in the rebuilding of mosques, toilets, and other public facilities. While government assistance appeared to be focused in and around the main cities of Mamuju and Majene, Crisis Aid Indonesia made a concerted effort to channel much-needed help towards some of the most remote, hard-to-reach communities. On arrival, groups of people would often come running, asking for nothing more than clean drinking water, a truly poignant reminder of the sheer desperation experienced by so many traumatized survivors. Our volunteers distributed hundreds of envelopes containing zakat money to some of the most needy families whose houses had been destroyed. Almost 10,000 buildings are believed to have been damaged by the sheer force of the earthquake, including homes, schools, mosques, businesses, as well as one of the city's main five-story hospitals, which collapsed, leaving patients and medical staff trapped beneath the rubble. Crisis Aid Indonesia collaborated with medical teams to supply much-needed medicine and equipment to help treat some of the survivors. Roadside banners offering spiritual comfort and knowledge were displayed around the earthquake zone, reminding the community to be patient during times of calamity. Competitions, games, and other trauma healing related activities were carried out by our volunteers to help children come to terms with this tragedy. On behalf of our Indonesian brothers and sisters, we would like to thank you for your generous donations, without which none of our relief work would have been possible. Please continue to support us so that we can continue to support them.